Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about loop control structures part 5. Okay, continuously we are making lot of videos on loop control structures. Why? Because this is the concept is very important for you. Okay, now today we are discussing about three programs. That is, write a Java program to print factors of a given number, and write a Java program to print some of the factors of a given number, and the third program is write a Java program to print the number of factors of a given number. These three are helpful for writing prime number program and perfect number program in the next sessions. Okay, that is the reason today we are discussing about these three programs. Okay, the first one is write a Java program to print factors of a given number. So before discussing about this, I need to tell one small story about that. The thing is, if I take n, the number of factors are in between 1 to n, and which number is divisible by n and then remainder is 0, then it is called a factor. Let us take an example of n is equal to 6, then 6 mod 1, 6 mod 2, 6 mod 3, 6 mod 4, 6 mod 5, and 6 mod 6. 6 mod 1 remainder is 0, 6 mod 2 remainder is 0, this remainder is 0, this remainder is 2, this remainder is 1, and this remainder is 2. So that the factors of 6 are 1, 2, 3, and 6. This is what the story behind the concept of factors. Now I need to print 1, 2, 3, and 6 for when I am input as 6. Okay. So for that program, for this, I will write the program like this. For int, it starts with 1, I less than equal to n, I plus plus, if n mod I is equal to 0, we need to print I. So this is what exactly the n as an input. So automatically it prints the factors. And the second one, write a Java program to print the sum of the factors of a given number. Same program, small changes are happening. So let us take, already we know that the factors of 6 are 1, 2, 3, and 6. The sum is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6, that is equal to 12. If I take 5, 1 and 5 are the factors, 1 plus 5, that is equal to 6 is the factor value. I hope you understand. Now I am writing the program. For int I is equal to 1, I less than equal to n, I plus plus, initially we need to take sum is equal to 0 if n mod I is equal to 0, then sum plus is equal to I, and finally we need to print sum. So here n is an input for the program. So let us take small example and I will compute to give the results. So tracing the process, n, I, n mod I, sum initially 0, n is equal to 4, I is equal to 1. So this is the first level of the values. Now 4 mod 1, so the remainder is 0. Okay, so I need to add sum is equal to sum plus I, so 1 is added. Now I will become 2, 4 mod 2 is equal to 0, so 1 plus 2, that is equal to 3. So again 3, 4 mod 3 is equal to 1, so the result is 3, will not reflect. Now that is equal to 4, 4 mod 4 is equal to 0, so 7. Finally, now it will become 5, the process will be stopped. Finally, we got the value of 7. This is the way it works. Okay, I think you understand betterly towards this program. Now, the last program of the today, write a Java program to print number of factors of a given number. So, let us take 6. 1, 2, 3 and 6 are the factors we said. So the number of factors are 4. Similarly, if you take 4, 1, 2 and 4, so the number of factors of 3. If I take 5, 1 and 5, so the number of factors are 2. So for this, we are writing the program. So initially we take count is equal to 0 for int I is equal to 1 to I less than equal to n I plus plus if n mod I is equal to 0, this is true, then we increment the count to next level and finally we print the count. Automatically you will get the result. So similarly, we need to trace the program with 6 numbers, n, I, n mod I is equal to 0, count is initially 0, so this is 6 and this is 1, okay. Now, this is 1, 6 mod 1 is equal to 0, so count initially 0. Count plus 1, that is equal to 0 plus 1, that is equal to 1. So now 2, 6 mod 2 is equal to 0. So 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. Again 3, 6 mod 3 is equal to 0. 2 plus 1, that is equal to 3. So 4, 6 mod 4 is equal to 2, no change. Again 5, 6 mod 5 is equal to 1. So no change. Now 6, 6 mod 6 is equal to 0, so 3 plus 1, that is equal to 4. Now it will become 7, so the process will be stopped. The final result is 4. So I think I hope you understand how to find number of factors in nothing but the count, how many factors are available for a particular number. In the previous program, we are discussing about some of the factors. This is also one of the important program. Similarly, initially these two programs are come with the base of printing the factors. If you know this logic, we know these two are simultaneously. Apart from this, the next programs like perfect number, it also depends upon the factors. Prime number, it also depends upon the factor. So if you understand these three programs, the next section will be very easy for you to understand, better understanding of the concept. Thank you.